Oh, well.
Hi, I'm Mark. I used to be a senior artist at Blizzard Entertainment, and now I teach art for a living.
I know you've been struggling with shading your art, and I'm here to help.
What? You haven't?
Get real. In the next few minutes of this Oscar-worthy new episode of my weekly series that I've been calling YouTube Art School, I'm going to teach you how to shade anything. Shading, of course, is what gives our art the illusion of volume, of 3D, even though we're drawing on a 2D surface. It looks hard, but it's easy. And I'll show you how to get better at it.
Uh-oh. Oh, quickly, let's get this class started.
All right, class is in session and pay attention. This week, I'm going to show you how to go from this to this, to eventually something like this. There are some steps to build up to that, of course, like any skill. So we'll look at those first. I've split the class into three levels with things to practice at each level to get the most XP points and get good ASAP. I repeat this to my group of students almost every week, but shading is a lot like speed in art. It's more a symptom of good fundamentals than it is something that you should be concerned about too much. But there are certainly things that you can and should practice to avoid shading like an amateur, which more often than not can actually make the art worse than not adding any shading. You'll find all the key points marked in the timeline for easy access. Now, all that's left before you can level up your art is to pay the class fee of either one like or one sub. Because if you don't, let's just get started. At level 1, we'll quickly be going over the basics to make sure that we're able to tell good shading from bad shading. It's simple, really. Good shading will be able to give a 2D shape the appearance of 3D, while bad shading will just look like mud or dirt, not particularly adding anything good to the 2D shape. The main thing that I want to emphasize here is that bad shading is primarily a problem with the basics. Your brush control, to be exact. If you can draw or paint clean shading from one side of a rectangle like this to the other, and have it be a linear progression from black to white, or you know, whatever color, then you'll do great with the rest. That's what we're looking for. If you're having a hard time doing this, select a soft brush. It makes things a million times easier, literally. You can also do the same thing with a pencil, same idea. You just want to start pressing really hard on one end and gradually press lighter and lighter as you make your way towards the other side. At first, practice on simple shapes like this, going from one color to the other in as smooth a gradient as possible. If you've been shading your characters already, but you're wondering why it doesn't really look that good with shading, this is probably why: the quality of your gradient. There might be other reasons, of course, but that's usually it. I also recommend using the full range of values all the time, from pure black to pure white. That way, with the shading on its own layer, we can always adjust the layer opacity to increase or decrease the contrast. Another exercise to try after you feel more comfortable doing these would be to add some volume to 2D shapes, kind of like making these feel like thick Play-Doh shapes laying on a table. It's just like the gradients that we've been doing here, but you just add it all around the shape. The more the gradient reaches in, the thicker the shape will appear. Wow, magic. At level 2 now, it's time to practice the building blocks of shading. Simple volumes, spheres, boxes, cylinders, and cones. If you can shade these, you can shade anything to reasonable quality. It's true. Almost any object can be recreated with parts of these volumes arranged in different ways. An arm, that's kind of just like a cylinder. The torso, kind of like a blobby cylinder bent a little bit. You approach everything that way. We're going to go over the simple way to shade first, aka no light source, and then the hard way with a light source. Oh my god. To shade without a light source, you kind of have to imagine your gaze is the light source. So I guess there's always a light source. Or try to look at these and mentally calculate which part of the volume is closer to you. Take a sphere, for example. Pretty simple. The center will be the closest point to us, the viewer. If you look at the same thing from the side, where the sphere is here and we're to the side, still looking at the sphere, you can see the shortest distance to the sphere is right here, right in the middle. That's where the sphere will be shaded the lightest. That's where the light reaches the most directly. Knowing we start from black to make use of the full value range, all we have to do now is create a soft gradient from the center to the edge, and we have a sphere. For the other volumes, slightly more complicated, but it's the same idea. Looking at this cube, the corner here will be the closest to us, so we just gotta select the face that's the least distorted by perspective to find out which is facing us most directly. If it's distorted by perspective a lot, it means that it's not facing us as directly. If we get more technical, it's the face that will have the most even corner angles, like all four corners closer to 90 degrees. The more it faces us, the lighter it is. This one here, on the other hand, very distorted, very narrow, not facing us as much. It's facing the top more than anything, aka not as much light we'll be able to reach, and it'll look darker. And then quick note about edges here, just select the brightest color of the two connected faces and light it up a bit more. Corners catch the most light always. Once you can do this more easily with the soft brush, try practicing your pen dexterity by using a hard brush and very lightly apply light the same way. To get rid of the super hard edges, you just gotta color pick the resulting in-between color and use that as the new color to blend in the edges even more. Kinda like that. Voila. Now, let's add some spice by introducing a light source. Just one, nothing crazy. Don't panic. The difference here will just be that instead of adding more light to the faces closest to us, we'll just add more light to the faces pointing at the light source most directly, not us. To start playing around with light sources like this, start with simple angles like a light coming from the side or coming straight from the top. Here we can start with the sphere, and if this light source is shooting light particles at the sphere, the left side of the sphere will be the first hit, aka the brightest. Same with the cylinder and the cone. All the edges closest to the light source get brighter. For the box, we do the same steps again. Which side is facing the light most directly? Probably the face in the back here that we can't see, and this one facing us too. The other faces are not facing the light at all, so they don't get much. Once again, look at the quality of the shading. A smooth transition from dark to light. And now if you feel like this could be better, you're right. You can also add a little bit of light coming from the opposite direction of the light to make it look better. Some bounce light. And that's level 2. When you can do this comfortably, level 3 shouldn't be too much of a jump from here. Add to level 3, it's time to combine. Combine multiple of these geometric shapes and try shading them the same way. Maybe blend the intersection to create a weird 3D shape like this. Seems like a strange thing to do maybe, but this right here is exactly what you'll do when shading anything. Let's take our character here. How can we break down parts of the silhouette into simpler volumes? Like this maybe. Shade these just like we did in the last chapter and booyakash! We have some basic shading on the leg and the body. Can you tell which kind of shading I used here? Yes, that's right. The first version, where we shade everything closest to us, lighter. No light source. But we can do the same thing again, except with a light coming from the side once more. Easy, we're still shading simple volumes. When you think of shading this way, everything becomes a lot more manageable. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, this doesn't look epic. But this is only the first step. We've been working on a single layer so far, set to multiply, focusing on the big details. So let's pop a new one and repeat the same process again, but with the smaller details this time. If we zoom in on the belly, for example, she's got some abs and, you know, different surfaces here that are facing in different directions. Still, those smaller details can also be simplified into simpler geometric shapes. What would that look like here? Ooh, well, that makes things much easier to shade now, doesn't it? Of course, it's a little dark now, but remember, we have each of these two on their own layers, and so we can quickly adjust the opacity. Oh, that's better. And now, just like we did here when we blended the edges to get a softer, continuous surface, we can do the same thing again. For something done in a few seconds. That's not bad. I'm working on a character here, but this works the same way for everything. If anything, shading characters is probably the hardest. This method here is meant to give you a great starting point for your shading. From here, especially for characters, you'll want to pull up a bunch of reference images to polish up the result and really get all the subtleties on the surface of the body. And once again, we can use a light coming from the side to get a different kind of shading. Still using the same logic. Think of big, simple volumes first, shade those, then move on to the smaller details and repeat the same thing again. Either way, I hope this was helpful. That's the end of the class. Real quick, I want to mention my complete art education program because I have a huge discount on it until the end of the month only, celebrating the 4-year anniversary, just for a few days. Check the details in the video description. Also, if you've been wondering about the brush that I usually use for shading, it's the one called MB Skin Cavity, but I have a few variants on that one too. And it's from my advanced painter set that you can grab in the top right corner of the screen right here. Or grab my other set for absolutely free, also in the top right corner of the screen, or down in the description. If you have any requests for class topics, don't hesitate to shoot them down in the comments below, because as you know, I read every comment. Still past 700,000 subscribers, because I love you. Make sure you have notifications turned on to be on time for class next week, or else...